Imagine what can happen when we have a real life stories book for Canada, when we have a real life stories book for China, when we have a real life stories book for Scotland, for Rwanda, for Kenya. Imagine what could happen. Local people's stories about what God has done for them. Imagine. Oh, it's a big vision, but I serve a big, 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 big God. Every member at every church can do this. The shy people can do it. The bashful can do it. Everybody can do this. It's so easy. But you can't change a non-witnessing church to a witnessing church overnight. It takes time. We didn't do this overnight. It took 5 years. And you know what? The truth is, we still don't have it all together. I had a person come to me today and say, you know, I need to write my testimony. I need to get it done because I know God wants to use me in other places of ministry, and I need a release, and I don't feel until I share what Jesus has done for me that I could have that release. And I was able to pray for that person. It took time, but they're going to write their story now to the glory of God and allow God to use them. It took years, but it's happening. Well, let me go kind of back to the beginning now. When I was a three-day-old Christian, a young man of only 78 years old came to my home church to teach us how to do something that God showed him. And he taught us to take our stories of our lives and where we were and how we met Jesus and what Jesus has done for us. Well, that young man of 78 years old is now a young man, I believe, of 92 years old. And he's my friend. And he's right here. Give the Lord a hand clap for him. What he taught me to do is going all over the world. And when he goes before Jesus, he's going to share in the crowns of glory. Because when I go, he goes with me. And when those I'm teaching, the evangelist under me, when they go, we both go with them. And as we keep training and raising up, the anointing is getting stronger, the anointing is getting greater, and the vision is getting bigger, and we're going to reach the world for Jesus. Thank you, Lord. But being only 3 days in the Lord, I felt like the man of God taught it, so I better go do it. Young Christians do them kind of things. But some of us veterans, we got stubborn streaks. Nobody here, of course. Turn your Bibles to the book of Revelation, chapter 12. And they overcame him, Satan, the devil, by the blood of the Lamb, by what Jesus did, and by the word of their testimony. So you see, Jesus did all he's going to do. It's done. So now we got to join our testimony with what the blood of the Lamb accomplished. And they loved not their lives unto the death. They were willing to share what Jesus did for them if it meant martyrdom, if it meant being killed, if it meant being executed. Well, when Brother Ray taught that, that was my first church. I went home, and the very night he taught it, that's interesting. Lord just reminded me of something. Where are you at, Michelle? Is she in here? Hey, girl. That one up there, the youngest member in the church at the time, Sunday morning, the first time I taught it, she went home and wrote her testimony. Emailed it to me before I even got home. Before I even got home. But the night he taught it, I went home and wrote it out right then. Had it typed up. Went to the print shop, ran off just 25 copies. I started to use them as the Holy Spirit would lead. And I'm sitting at my desk where I do my work and pay the bills and take care of business. As I'm sitting there, the Holy Spirit speaks to me. I'm 4 days in the Lord at this point. You know that God can speak to a baby Christian? Do you know that God can sometimes get through to a baby Christian a whole lot faster than he can some veterans? And do you know those baby Christians obey a whole lot faster? They don't say, I got to pray about it for a month and a half. Whew. Ouch. I'm sitting at my desk, and the Holy Ghost speaks to me. Mail David your testimony. David and his wife had rented a house from me about 30 days before. David met me when I was still a heathen. And when I say heathen, I was a heathen. The Holy Spirit said, mail him your testimony. If I wouldn't have wrote it, he couldn't have prompted me to use it. We have to take steps. We have to do what we know to do, and God does the rest. God does this. When we do the natural and take it as far as we can, God does the supernatural. So I obeyed God. I took that. Actually, I took three testimonies because I wrote mine. No, I didn't. Never mind. Let me back up. I don't think I did at this point. I just had mine. But I mailed my testimony to David. Got a call a little later, and it's David's wife. She said, Jim, I got to thank you for sending that to David. You see, David met me before I knew Christ. He later told me, he said, Jim, I could tell you didn't even want me in your house. He said, Jim, you weren't concerned with anything but my money and get out my face. That's the way Jim was. I was strictly business. Somebody come close to me, I grab my wallet. What are you after? Didn't trust nobody. And David could see that. But David read my testimony. David read how one night I ended up at church and gave my heart to Jesus. David read how my life was changed and he felt the love of God coming off of that testimony. He went to his wife and he said, you know, if God could change Jim, if God could change Terry, if God could change, put your name in there. Whew. But if God could change Jim, there's hope for David. I agree. All the Davids. A few weeks passes by, and I'm out on my porch, and I'm looking down the driveway, and I see a man coming down the driveway. I'm looking at him. I'm thinking, who is this? He's smiling from ear to ear. Who is this? It's David. David comes up on my porch. He shakes my hand. He said, I got to tell you. He said, I went to church on Sunday. He said, I gave my heart to Jesus. He said, three members of my family gave their lives to Jesus.